I mean, it's like Sora level impressive.
The first image is okay.
What the f***? Why?
Yeah, the content was flagged.
What the f*** is this? Hey, this is Ayhan. From now on, I'm making tutorial videos. I'm just kidding. But I swear to God, this is still relevant. Today, we're looking at a tool that is called RunwayML. And everyone talks about this one. So I thought, let's give it a shot. Today, I'm trying to make an impressive short film, but only using the credits I am getting at the free tier. That is, if my credits hit zero, the game's over. We will explore the feature set of RunwayML and especially focus on the text-to-video model of RunwayML. Let's give it a shot, shall we? Gen-3 is only available for paying customers, so we have to stick with Gen-2, because that's the point of the video, staying in the free tier. Oh, and by the way, I'm going into this completely blind. I haven't used it before. Let's just start ahead and try out a prompt, like cinematic action, documentary film, a programmer sits in front of the computer and hacks the box. Suddenly, he gets up and breakdances. What lighting do we want? Ambient room lighting, okay. So what we have here, settings. This one is interesting. We have a seed that is an identifier for this prompt. And if you have a fixed seed, then every subsequent prompt will be in the context of this one. So the same lighting, the same context. So you can create new scenes that are aware of the context of the scene before. Let's see how good this works. So we have like presets, cinematic, abandoned, concept art, digital art, like 35 millimeters. Things filmmakers would love, but maybe let's stick with no preset. We can choose the aspect ratio, like 4 to 3, 21 by 9. But let's stick to the standard tier 2. All right. And let's try to generate it. So we are curing right now. I will skip these because they take not too long, but too long for this video. And we have our first results. Let's check it out. Okay, that's not exactly what I had in mind. I mean, you must understand that these models are mostly trained on stock image and stock videos. But I could imagine that there would be at least hundreds of videos of people doing breakdance, so I don't know how this failed so hard. We can see the metadata, like the resolution, and we lost credits. We have 486 credits left. Okay, maybe the hacks the box is a little bit too ambiguous for it. Let's try another one. Cinematic action, documentary film, a cat jumps on a desk and accidentally pushes a button on the keyboard of a computer, which makes the monitor screen go red with an exclamation mark on it. And let's delete this one. Ambient room lighting is okay. Maybe let's take the anime style. I like anime cats. Okay, we're in the queue. We can see the scenes we have generated on the right side. And let's explore this one. So we have the fixed seat. I assume that it will be more or less the same setting as the not breakdancing guy, but a cat that jumps on the table. Let's see. Let's just skip to the result. So here we have it. I mean, I don't know what exactly happens here. It's like morphing into something else. I don't know. The cat doesn't jump. The monitor isn't turning red, but the room is. At least there's a keyboard. I think that's a win. But when we look at the breakdancing or non-breakdancing boy again, yeah, I'm not sure if that will cost filmmakers their jobs anytime soon. I don't know. Okay, let's try another one. Cinematic action, documentary film. A girl runs through a labyrinth of bushes. Horror movie lighting. And we removed the seed so that we have a whole new context. And let's try to use the cinematic preset this time and generate. Oh, wait, let's try the 3x4 format and now generate. Okay. And we lost credits. Getting interesting now. Let's jump to the solution. And here we have it. Okay, that's a labyrinth of bushes. I see that. The girl is not exactly running. What is she doing? playing tic-tac-toe. The angle is really weird. Oh, and also you could use free previews if you don't want to spend credits, so you can get a taste of what you will get later, but the free previews are unavailable right now because some kind of increased demands and wait times seems like a lot of people using RunwayML right now. So we have to spend the credits every time we want to try something. That makes it even more interesting. Okay, let's try something else. A girl runs through the labyrinth, wears a red dress at night. We remove the seed again and clear the preset. Okay, let's generate it and see what we will get from this. The aspect ratio is still 3:4. All right, here we got it. Looks a little bit more interesting than the first one. But yeah, I mean, yeah, the dress is red and everything else is red too. And it's pretty abstract. And yeah, the thing about Runway Gen-2 video is that it's text to video or image to video. So let's try image to video and check if that's working any better. Let's just go to ChatGPT DALL-E, same prompt. All right, this looks a little bit more not like dancing, but maybe you try it again. Just hex the box. Okay, cool. Let's add it here. Let's make a fixed seat in here. Okay, some of the settings are not available if you are using image to text. Let's see what it generates. What the fuck is this? Why is this left hand disappearing all of a sudden? Okay, yeah, this is probably the most Gen AI video I have ever seen in my life. This reminds me of the Will Smith eating spaghetti kind of stuff. Okay, let's try to improve it a little bit. Let's skip the suddenly he breakdances part and just say a programmer is coding on the computer and regrets his life choices, period. Oh, we have a motion brush where we can control how much motion and the directional control of motions in the video. Okay, let's try this one out. Maybe the lamp in the background that it... So I would assume that the first brush would move the lamp back and forth a little bit. That should be working, right? Let's check the result. Oh my God, what the... All right, yeah, that seems humanly possible. Yeah, this is just like I thought. It's not working that well. I'm really not sure if we can do a great and impressive short film, at least not with Gen-2 video. Let's try another thing like third person perspective. What? Why is the camera not behind the person? Oh, third person is wrong. It should have been over the shoulder. Okay, let's try the cheat mode because in the real life, you will combine multiple tools to have some kind of short movies or things like that. I will use DALL-E to have the images I want as an impression for the video generation AI model, because that won't cost me any credits. I mean, I make the rules, I don't care. So let's try it with... image of a pink-haired girl in her mid-20s. Steampunk setting. Girl has a mechanical keyboard-esque sword strapped on her back. And I tried to put some Final Fantasy VII references to it to have the like the Buster sword in the back, but that didn't work, so I said to ignore the Final Fantasy VII part, and it turned out well. That's just more or less like I imagined it to be. So now the opponents. A man with long black hair in a suit has scratches over his face from a fight, wears a monocle and a green fedora with a feather in it. Also steampunk setting, but a darker corner of the city. What is this? Okay, no blood. Okay, it won't lose the blood. Let's try it again. Yeah, no blood and doing the exact opposite. Great. I'm pretty sure I will not be allowed to upload this bloody image to Runway, but let's try it anyways. So same prompt here, but with the picture. Looks to the camera, ready to begin a fight. All right, and let's fix the seat because we want to have a short movie that is aligned within the scenes. All right, let's generate it and skip to the results. I mean, that's, yeah, There's some morphing in there with the weapon, but in general, it's pretty okay. I mean, that was the easy prompt, right? So let's go on with her opponent. All right, let's paste it here. Paste the prompt. With long black hair and a suit, scratches over his face from a fight. Wears a monocle and green fedora with a feather in it. Steampunk setting, horror movie lighting. So let's try it out. The seat is fixed.
Yeah, the content was flagged.
Sure. This makes perfect sense. Let's have a quick montage how I fix the scratches in this face. Not working. Okay, this one is it. Okay, this one is working. Oh, let's paste it here. And the prompt should be more or less the same. Let's just remove the scratches and replace it with scars. I mean, yeah, this is close enough to a video. Our credits are running really low. We are at 97 credits at the moment. Let's try to come to an end here. So, do people around the world drink this, or is it just a German thing? It's from South America, so I guess. Just write it in the comments. I'm really curious. So, the girl and the man stand in front of each other in the abandoned factory, ready to fight. All right, let's see. I don't see any girl and any... Yeah, it's missing. It's completely nonsense. I mean, it's just like animating the images I feed it. It doesn't seem like the prompt has any effect at all. I mean, this is the most generic animation you can do with a image, right? So why is there even a prompt if it's not working? I don't have a good feeling about this. Okay, let's try this next scene. The girl and the man stand in front of each other in the abandoned factory, ready to fight. Ready to be disappointed, I guess. These are not the characters I introduced. And also they seem hollow. Ready to fight? Like, did the model interpret that they are not fighting with weapons? I don't know. Okay, I have created an image where we have the abandoned factory we have introduced and the characters we have introduced. Give it to the model and give it the prompt. The girl and the man stand in front of each other in the abandoned factory, ready to fight with their weapons, to make it crystal clear. Let's see how this works. All right, the first image is okay. What the f***? How is... Why? I don't even know what to say. Why is it starting off so good and then deciding to just f*** it up? Like it's mocking me. I don't know. Okay, let's try it again. I will create a new image of these characters. Let me just use DALL-E for this. Okay, let's just have a quick montage. So we have the images, I have merged them together, and we feed it to the model. Yeah, I lost the top of the head of the fedora, but I think it won't matter anyway, because that's in detail the model will screw up anyway. So let's try it again. Let's remove the fixed seat. Maybe the fixed seat was the problem, that the morphing of the characters I introduced into those normal persons was somehow the result of the clip we had before. So let's try this one out without a fixed seat. Let's see. Okay, starting off good. Okay, it insists in morphing these characters into completely other persons. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we can use it. I'm not sure. Okay, let's remove the image and try the end scene. Zoom out, man and girl are running towards each other. Moments before their weapons clash, fade out. Okay, let's see. This is the last try we have. And the result doesn't look too promising. Let's check it anyways, but I have a bad feeling about this. Oh, everything is wrong with this. First, where are the weapons? Second, they are not running towards each other. We have no zoom out, and they are even holding hands. I don't know. That's completely wrong. And there's no fade out.
Okay, I'm trying not to be too hard to this because it's Gen 2. Gen 2 will be somewhere around Will Smith eating spaghetti era. But making an epic, impressive short film from this, I'm not sure if it's possible. But let's try it out and see it in 3, 2, 1. I assume that you have noticed that my credits were dropping a lot from 1 second to the other. Oops. And that's because I played around with other features of RunwayML and the generative features were using those credits. So maybe we could have done a better job. I don't know. I'll release another video about these features shortly after this one. I'm really curious about the improvements from Gen 2 to Gen 3 because the demo videos on the webpage of RunwayML are really impressive actually. I mean, it's like Sora level impressive. And I've talked in my videos about generative models for video will never be publicly available. So I'm actually really excited to try this one out. Let me know in the comments which plan I should choose. This one or this one. All right, let me know if you want to see more about this. Have a good time to spend your free credits and don't use the prompts I used because I did this so you don't have to. Take care.